everyone. Today I'm going to teach you how to make some cookies using cricket powder and then decorating them like cicadas and some of their lookalikes. I wanted to start by thanking Chirps, who is the company that makes the cricket powder that I'm going to be using today. They graciously sponsored our video and are also providing us with some cookie mixes that you can win if you make your own cookies and decorate them with cicadas. And I will tell you more about that at the end of the video. Before you start baking, make sure that you've refreshed your food safety knowledge. You can find the link in the description below for a quick review. All right, let's start baking. So to start with, I am getting out my dishes and the dry ingredients I need. I'm doing a half recipe, so I'm only using 1 teaspoon of baking powder. And now I'm going to add 1 1/4 cups all-purpose flour. So the next thing I'm going to add is my cricket powder. Again, we got that from Chirps. Thank you, Chirps, for providing our prizes at the end of the video. Entomophagy, which is eating insects, is actually a really nutritious and sustainable way to get your protein. One thing to quickly note, though, is if you are allergic to shellfish, then you probably want to avoid any sort of insects because you may also have an allergy to them. They've got a lot of the same proteins. But for those who aren't allergic, they're really delicious and they add this really great nutty flavor to your cookies as well as some great protein. Now I'm just going to dump everything in there together to get it all mixed up. So I'm adding my cricket powder, my flour, and my baking powder, which also there's a little tiny bit of salt in there that I forgot to mention before. All right, and now that it's all in the bowl, I'm just going to mix it up. If you have a stand mixer, that's honestly probably easier to use. I'm not going to use one at any point in this video because, well, I don't have one myself. So you get to watch me stir everything in together with a little spoon. And now it's time to add our butter and sugar. So I'm pulling out my butter. I am using, again, 1/2 cup of butter because I am doing a half recipe, and then also 1/2 cup of sugar. Next, I am going to put those in a bowl together and just mix them all together. All right, now it's time to add the final ingredients. So in the recipe, it says to add vanilla extract, but unfortunately, I don't have vanilla extract. So instead, I'm going to switch it out for licorice flavoring. I really like licorice. I think it's going to pair well with the cricket powder. We will find out. But I bet if you use vanilla, it'll taste just as good in the end. The other thing I'm going to add now is an egg. Now I'm going to dump the egg into that butter and sugar mixture and then also dump in my licorice flavoring. And now that they're in there, I'm going to mix it all up together. Great, all mixed together. Now time to add the dry ingredients a little bit at a time. So I'm just adding a tiny bit, stirring, tiny bit, stirring, and keeping it going that way. And I'm finishing up adding the last bits of my dry mixture in here. Now the recipe says to mix the dough together for about 5 minutes. While I'm mixing this, I'm going to give you a quick cicada fact. If you're looking for a good place to go cicada watching, make sure you choose an area that's had trees for the last 17 years at the very least. Cicadas need to have access to trees nearly constantly for their whole lives. If you take away the tree, the cicada can't survive. All right, so now we're done mixing our dough. Now it's time to actually bake our cookies. First, I'm going to need a cookie cutter. I'm going to try this lid. Next, I need my rolling pin and a cookie tray with some parchment paper on it. Then finally, I'm going to pull out my cookie dough itself. So I don't have room on screen to actually roll this all out, so I'm going to do it off screen and come back. Once I had them cut out, I threw them in the oven and I baked them for about 7 to 10 minutes. And pulled them out, and here they are. They're a little bit more brown on the edges of some of them than I'd liked, but overall, I am pretty happy. They smell absolutely delicious. I can't wait to try them. When I'm drawing my cicadas onto my cookies, I'm going to pull out this cicadas and their lookalike sheet. You can download that off of the Purdue Cicada webpage. It's good for reference. And I've also got some sketches that I put together to try and make it easier for me to follow just the basic shape of a cicada. Now I'm going to pull out my frosting and start decorating. I'm using buttercream, but you can pick whatever you think works best for you. I'm going to start out by doing actually a lookalike of cicadas, the cricket. Since we have cricket powder in the cookies, I thought that would be a good place to start. So crickets have these sort of small, ovalish, roundish shaped heads that I'm going to start with. Then they've got a short little thorax and a longer plump abdomen. Then they have these cute little legs that one pair goes off to the front, and then the other two pairs tend to be pointed back. And the third pair looks extra strong for jumping. And then we've got these two little bits at the end as well that I'm adding on to make sure it's clear it's a cricket. And then the beautiful long antennas that crickets have. So that'll be my final touch for this cricket cookie. Okay, so now we're doing a cicada lookalike again, the grasshopper. This one is going to be in bright green. Doesn't quite look like that on my printout, but grasshoppers can be all sorts of colors. Notice they've got these nice little round heads, pretty short thorax, and then for the abdomen has these long wings right over the top of the abdomen. So they're in there tight, and then the abdomen itself rests underneath. Now grasshoppers, just like crickets, have got one pair of legs that's kind of more facing forward and they're much smaller. The second pair of legs is a little bit bigger and tends to be facing backwards. And then the third pair of legs is much thicker and more sturdy for making those big, powerful grasshopper jumps. And then they have some sort of medium-sized little antennas pointing towards the front, right up in the air like a pair of TV antennas. Oops, and I almost forgot to give my grasshopper a little eye. There we go. And now we're going to do the abdomen of the annual cicadas. So these are the cicadas that you probably see every year. And the abdomen, it's just a short little, almost sort of curved triangle shape with a few lines across it. Now we're going to add the green onto our annual cicadas. Their thorax and their head is green, so I'm going to attach the thorax first. Again, on cicadas, those are pretty short. The head, again, it's short and wide is the general rule for the shape of cicadas. Now I'm going to add on their little eyes. They're more brown, but I've already switched bags, so we're just going to make the eyes green in this case. And I'm going to give my annual cicada some little legs going off to the sides here and towards the back. Whoops! A little bit of the color didn't get fully mixed in there. Oh well, they'll just be a little extra green. Now I'm going to move on to the wings of the cicada. So these wings are long, they are transparent, and if you notice, they sort of curve along the edges. So I'm going to put one wing onto each side. And I'm going to draw in a few little wing veins just to represent what those look like. And ta-da, we've got our annual cicada. Remember, these are the ones that you see in August. Okay, so next on the list, I'm going to draw the cicada nymphs. So these are basically the baby cicadas that live underground for most of their life cycle. Again, they've got these short little heads, and then their thorax is a much larger section. And then finally, they've got this big, thick abdomen with these lines going across it, which are the different little segments of the abdomen. They are much sort of stouter than the crickets. You'll notice they're much shorter and their legs are kind of all clumped together, and the front legs are really good for digging around because they need to do that underground. And they've got these short little cute antenna at the end. Mine are a little bigger than the actual picture, but I just wanted to add them anyway. Then finally, I'm going to add in the wing pads. So now I'm going to finish off my cicada nymph with a bright red eye. When they are crawling up out of the ground, these eyes get particularly visible, so you can kind of tell when a cicada is ready to emerge by finding those eyes. All right, and next I'm going to do the same thing again, but this one is going to end up being the cicada exuvia, which is the shell that the cicadas leave behind when they come up out of the ground and turn into adult cicadas. It's kind of like when a caterpillar turns into a butterfly, but it's a little bit of a different process with cicadas, but it's the same idea. All right, now we're gonna move on to drawing our adult cicadas. This is what we're all here for. I'm gonna start out with some brown because, as you can see, the body of these cicadas is brown. I've got that round head and then this short, stocky thorax, and again, a pretty short and compact abdomen. Whoops, that's a little uneven. I'll just even it up here a little bit with the frosting. No one's gonna notice, right? And then I'm adding these segments on the abdomen as well. Now I'm going to add on the little short little antenna that the adult cicadas have, and the legs. These are strong legs. They need to be able to grip onto the trees, so they're again not nearly as long and powerful for jumping, but they're great for clinging onto a tree. And we're done with the first part of our adult cicadas. Now we're going to add our wings to our 17-year cicadas. And for these wings, again, they're nice and long, and they are more of a kind of golden color than the body of the rest of the cicada. Not quite as yellow as my frosting, but you know, you can't get perfect color on frosting every time. I'm gonna add some wing veins across. There are many more on the actual cicada ring, but I don't have the space to fit those on my cookies, unfortunately. And now this is where I would show you adding the bright red eyes, but unfortunately I lost that footage, so just imagine the red eyes, you can see them at the end. And that is all of our cookies.
We've got all of our lookalikes, the grasshopper, the cricket, and the annual cicada. That one you'll only see in August, remember. And then we have the 17-year cicada nymph exuvia, and of course the adult.
This is the one that we're going to be seeing 1.5 million of them per acre in some areas in the next few weeks. They have bright red eyes, brown bodies, and golden wings. So I personally cannot wait to see them. I'm celebrating a little early with these cookies. And please, if you do decide to make some cicada cookies yourself, take a picture and tag us on Facebook so that we can see them. We are going to be giving away bags of Chirps cookie mix, so those are chocolate chip cookies, to people who send us pictures of their cicada cookies. Thank you again to Chirps for providing those. I can't wait for all of you to get a chance to try them.
They're absolutely delicious. And remember, whether you made regular sugar cookies or sugar cookies with cricket powder, please do tag us so we can see them. We'd love to see all your creative ways of celebrating the emergence of the cicadas.
And I will say, the licorice flavor and the nutty flavor of the cricket powder mix together very well. I highly recommend it if you're a licorice person. And with that, we're all done. Send us your pictures. Get out and enjoy the cicadas.